Welcome to our Treatment for Stage 1, 2, and 3 Kidney Cancer Quick Guide. Your age, the size and stage of your cancer, and your overall health will determine your treatment options. If you are older, have a very small cancer, or have a serious medical condition like heart disease, your doctor may suggest watching the cancer instead of performing an invasive procedure to treat it. This is called active surveillance or observation.
Cancer treatments can be divided into two types, localized and systemic. Surgery and radiation are localized treatments. They remove or kill the cancer cells in or near the kidney. Chemotherapy, targeted therapy, and immunotherapy are systemic treatments. They kill cancer cells that might be anywhere in the body.
First, we'll talk about surgery. Surgery is most often used for stage 1, stage 2, or stage 3 kidney cancer. Surgery is not used as often for stage 4 kidney cancer. We will talk in detail about treating stage 4 or metastatic kidney cancer in our Treating Metastatic Stage 4 Kidney Cancer Quick Guide. If the tumor is small, your surgeon may be able to remove it without taking out the entire kidney. This is called a partial nephrectomy. It is also called kidney-sparing or nephron-sparing surgery. This is how a kidney looks before and after a kidney-sparing surgery.
If a tumor is large or has moved into tissue outside of the kidney, your surgeon will take out the whole kidney. This is called nephrectomy or a radical nephrectomy. Nearby lymph nodes and fatty tissue around the kidney may also be removed. If the tumor is near the adrenal gland, which sits on top of the kidney, it may also be removed. This is how this area of your body will look after the whole kidney has been removed.
There are two primary types of surgery, open and minimally invasive. Open surgery is the traditional type of surgery done with a scalpel. It is most often recommended if the tumor is 4 inches, 10 centimeters, across or larger, or when the tumor has spread into nearby organs or blood vessels. Minimally invasive surgery may be an option, especially if your tumor is smaller than 4 inches or 10 centimeters. Minimally invasive surgery uses several smaller cuts or incisions. When done with a laparoscope, it is called laparoscopic surgery. For this procedure, the surgeon uses special tools that are about a half inch in diameter and a small camera. The tools are inserted through small cuts in the abdomen. Minimally invasive surgery can also be done robotically. This is called robot-assisted laparoscopic surgery. In this procedure, the surgeon controls robotic arms to perform the cancer removal. For any surgery, surgeon skill and expertise is critical. Ask your surgeon how many of these surgeries they have done and how many they do in a given month or year.
Some people with kidney cancer choose an approach other than surgery. This is typically because they have other severe health problems. Options for these patients may include cryoablation or cryotherapy. This procedure uses very cold gas to freeze and kill the tumor cells. It's usually performed by an interventional radiologist or urologist. Radiofrequency ablation. During this procedure, the doctor puts a probe that uses heat to kill cancer cells directly into the tumor. Arterial embolization. Your doctor will insert a special material into the artery to keep the tumor from getting the blood it needs to grow. This procedure is also sometimes used to shrink the tumor before surgery or to reduce pain when the tumor can't be removed. Radiation therapy. This may be used to treat the primary tumor if surgery is not an option. Typically, radiation is only used to relieve pain or bleeding that might develop when the cancer spreads to other parts of the body.
Now, we'll talk about systemic treatments for kidney cancer. These treatments are used to kill cancer cells that have left the kidney and are in other parts of the body. The systemic therapy people are most familiar with is chemotherapy, but traditional chemotherapy is not often used to treat kidney cancer. These cancers respond better to other types of anti-cancer drugs, like targeted therapies and immunotherapies. Systemic treatment is sometimes used before surgery to shrink a large tumor. It may also be used after surgery to treat kidney cancer that has a high risk of returning. More information about systemic treatments like targeted therapy and immunotherapy is in our information about treating metastatic kidney cancer.
There are tools that can help your doctor assess your risk of cancer returning within 5 years after surgery. These tools can help you and your doctor decide whether you could possibly benefit from additional treatment. See our Quick Guide Kidney Cancer Resources at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/kidney-cancer for an example of this kind of risk assessment tool. Talk to your doctors and ask them to help you understand what the risk of your cancer returning could be. Then ask them whether additional therapy, such as targeted therapy or immunotherapy, might be right for you. These additional treatments are explained later in this quick guide. Your treatment options may also include clinical trials. There are currently about 200 clinical trials taking place in the U.S. that are enrolling kidney cancer patients. Some are only open to patients with stage 4 kidney cancer. Others are for early stage kidney cancer patients. You can ask your doctor if there are clinical trials that are right for you. Go to our resources from the Quick Guide on Kidney Cancer at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/kidney-cancer. Learn more about cancer clinical trials on the Cancer Support Community's website, www.cancersupportcommunity.org/clinical-trials.
All kidney cancer patients in active treatment should have a written treatment plan so they know what to expect. All kidney cancer survivors who are not in active treatment should have a survivorship care plan. This is a document that includes information about the treatments you have had and the follow-up care you need. Your doctor may provide you with one. If not, see our Quick Guide Kidney Cancer Resources at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/kidney-cancer. Here you will find a list of resources to help you complete a survivorship care plan with your healthcare team.
As a kidney cancer survivor, you'll want to be prepared. Keep copies of all medical records and insurance payments. Know about the short and long-term side effects that you may experience following treatment. Learn what symptoms to be aware of that may suggest your kidney cancer has returned. Learn what symptoms to be aware of that suggest your kidney function has been impaired. Know if or how often you should see a nephrologist, an expert in diagnosing and managing diseases that affect how the kidneys function.
Also, having kidney cancer may place you at a higher risk of getting certain other types of cancer, especially if you were diagnosed with kidney cancer before the age of 50. These include bladder cancer, melanoma, skin cancer, prostate cancer, thyroid cancer, and a second cancer in the other kidney.
Taking steps to improve your overall health can help all cancer patients. You'll want to eat a healthy diet, get regular exercise, stop smoking, maintain or try to get to a healthy weight, limit how much alcohol you drink, and have access to resources for emotional support. Learn more about finding support on the Cancer Support Community website, www.cancersupportcommunity.org/find-support.
If you would like to learn more about treatment for metastatic or stage 4 kidney cancer, or if you want to know more about systemic treatments like targeted therapy and immunotherapy, watch our Treatment for Metastatic Stage 4 Kidney Cancer Quick Guide.